What's up, everybody? Welcome to a special Vietnamese episode of Phong Bros Food.
Most Vietnamese food in America is Southern style. Today, we're gonna be introducing you to this Central style.
Joining us today, you guys all know him, Viet swag boy, Richie Lee.
My family's from the South, but I'm excited to try Central style.
And making a special guest appearance from our hometown, R&B vocalist and Viet food connoisseur, Johnny Chim.
AKA Ja Chim.
Let's go.
Ooh, Central Vietnam, it's got its own style. Ooh, Central Vietnam, it's got its own style.
Hey, guys, Richie's looking real sleepy, man. Wake him up.
Hey, wake up, man. We're shooting a video.
Yo, he's always sleepy in our videos.
All right, hold on. Wake him up, man. I got it.
Before we do anything Vietnamese, you have to drink the coffee.
You have to start the morning with the coffee.
Yeah, dress, first of all, Johnny, you are Vietnamese.
I am. Let me get that straight. I am 100%, well, maybe not 100%, but I am Vietnamese.
Could we get two sentences of Paris by night? When we're referring to Southern Vietnam, Central Vietnam, Northern Vietnam,
yeah,
would you say that these are three distinct areas with three distinct cuisines?
For sure.
Yeah. So Central Vietnamese food, we're gonna be basing it mostly, I'd say the most central city that's most famous is Hue, which used to be the old capital back in the day.
You know your history.
So Richie, can you tell us about what it was like being in Hue?
Hue has a lot of Buddhist temples. It's really historic because it's a really old city. Really known for the food, so we went to a lot of restaurants, a lot of side street foods, a lot of cheap eats. That's what they call it, the cheap eat city.
What's from Central Vietnam?
We got Bún Mò Huế.
Hey.
We got Bánh Xèo.
Hey.
We got Bún Xào Gà Măng.
That's a proud Vietnamese right there. That's a proud Vietnamese.
All right, but this looks delicious. I've never had this before, and to me, when I read it, it looks like Bún Gà Xào Măng. Like
what actually pronounced Bún Gà Xào Măng. So what this is pretty much the Bún Gà is just the noodles and the chicken. And then the Xào Măng is just how they prepare it. So we got some roasted like chicken right here with some shallots on top, some nice fried shallots. You got the cabbage at the bottom.
We got some chicken soup and some bamboo. Vinaigrette with some cabbage too.
All right, everybody, we got Bumble Hue here. The Hue means it comes from the city of Hue, right?
Hold on, what does Bumbo mean? We know the Hue is the city.
Right, so the Bún just means noodles, and then the Bò is just the beef. So it's beef soup.
Other noodle soup, not pho. This is like the other noodle soup that you would say is on the rise.
This is what I'm saying. Think of Vietnam, you should think of pho, right? Mm. This is the soup that, okay. If you're feeling a little adventurous and you want some a little kick to it,
yeah,
this is definitely the new one.
All right, I gotta go in right, and start something because this is my favorite piece right here. What is this?
That's the pig knuckles.
Yeah, the pig knuckle.
Pig knuckle knuckle. Boom. What is that?
This is what we call Ja Luo. It's a nice cold cut. You get the coagulated pork blood right here.
Yeah.
So let's chop this thing. Open. This is definitely a textural thing.
In Chinese, this would be a piece of just brown tofu.
Now, we should note that the reason why Bumble Hue is presented in maybe a fancier way is because Hue used to be the capital city where a lot of the royal families used to eat this dish.
My man knows his history.
You have so many different flavors going on. The pork blood, you have the lettuce, you can squeeze in more cilantro, some mint leaves, you have the beef, and even the broth itself is a little bit more complex because it's supposed to be sweet, spicy, and tangy all at the same time.
Culinary treats from the city away. I can eat these treats like every single day.
Every single day.
All right, so you know how people mispronounce pho as pho? What are they gonna call Bumble Hue?
Well, what do you call it? I heard you call it.
I would say Bumble Hue, but I've heard it called Bumble Hue.
Bumba Hue.
Bumbo Hue.
Wrong. Bumba Hue.
Bamba ho.
A bamba ho.
A bamba ho.
A bumba way.
A bumba way.
A bumba way. In the jungle, the mighty jungle of Central Vietnam.
A bumba way.
Next up, Bun Sale with an X.
X E O. Crepes all day.
All right, so the first thing about Bun Sale is pronouncing the name Bun Sale because it starts X E O.
Sale, I think, means sizzling, right?
It's sizzling, yes.
Sale.
The first thing I notice is this looks like nothing I've ever seen from any Asian country ever before.
For sure.
Break that down for me. Explain to me why that is.
What's it
in a word, Richie?
French.
Le parlez-vous français? Comment allez-vous? Ne sais quoi de quoi me venir?
Are we talking about Lady Marmalade right now, or like?
So this is a little crazy because a lot of times people think that this is an omelet, in which this has no eggs in it at all.
Okay.
This is a crepe, and like Richie said, French. It was influenced by the French.
You got the shrimp going on. You got a little bit of pork belly, and in the inside, you also get a little bit of green sprouts, mung bean, and some daikon.
Or how do we eat this? Because I'm looking at this.
A lot of times I see a lot of people take the lettuce wrap and take a piece of the bansal, make it into a lettuce wrap, and then dip it. What I like to do is take this whole thing, put it in a bowl, and drench it with fish sauce.
Okay.
We got the good old cilantro.
Oh, shit, I'm tangled.
We got purple mint.
Okay.
Mustard lettuce.
Mustard lettuce.
Okay. Shout out to DJ Mustard.
Mustard on a crepe, yo.
Here's how I'm eating it, guys. Ooh, I actually have the lettuce making the wrap around
don't
the
bun
sale.
Don't hurt him.
So I got cilantro. I got purple mint. Ooh. I got the mustard leaf. I got the bun sale. I'm going in. Y'all ready?
Ooh, he's about to dive in.
Oh, got this.
It tastes really good because you have the cake baked-like element, which is the crepe, and then you have the fresh vegetables. But not only do you just have one type of fresh vegetable, you have multiple types of vegetables that have flavor.
So this is a vegetarian bun sale, which most places don't serve, but you want to flip the top, take the top. Oh, you
don't hurt them.
No.
So this is actually completely vegetarian, all the way down to the non-fish fish sauce.
Yo, I just love how Vietnamese food, you wrap everything in a leaf. Like, I like that. That's very cool to me. Fishless fish sauce. Let's go.
I'll say the fishless fish sauce definitely has a marked lack of fish taste.
Wild style, baby.
Oh, Lord.
All right.
The vegetarian one I actually enjoyed quite a bit too. I actually had a sweeter taste, even more than the fish sauce, because I think that sauce, the fishless fish sauce, is like a sweet soy, maybe beany fermented thing.
Fishless fish sauce, still delicious.
Yo, so that was it for Central Vietnamese food.
Whew.
You know what the interesting thing was? I just thought of this. When we were growing up in the Northwest, we just kind of said we were Asian, but we never really understood anything about being Asian, actually. I actually don't even think we talked about that, oh, you're Vietnamese and I'm Chinese.
As Asian as we got was Asian pride.
Yeah.
It was rice. It stopped at rice. Because everybody eats rice.
It stopped at rice.
Rice and your shoes off, and then you were Asian.
Exactly.
What percentage of Vietnamese people, even would you say Vietnamese Americans, even know the difference between Northern, Central, and Southern styles?
Very rare, man.
Once you learn about your parents' journey, I feel like that really is gonna spark something in you to go find out more.
Definitely.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing, learning about the history and things, getting into the culture, and not only that, but sharing it with other people that are not Vietnamese. It doesn't matter if even if you're Asian, with everybody.
Cheers to the motherland.
Cheers.
All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching that episode of Fun Bros Food. It was about Central Vietnam. Thank you, Richie. Thank you, Johnny, AKA Ja Chim.
Hey.
Check out this video right here. Check out this video right here. Let us know other cuisines that you want us to try in the comment section below. Believe me, we do want to get to them all. It's difficult. We will, though. Till next time, Fun Bros Food, we out.
Peace.